Walked out this morning, I don't believe what I saw. 100 billion bottles washed up on the shore. Seems I'm not alone in being alone. 100 billion castaways looking for a home. Famous words of The Police from their song, A Message in a Bottle. Great song, love the band. Just when I heard Message in a Bottle, I just hear it in my head.
Oh, I get it. I don't know the song, but I stan Lindsay, so I'm just gonna agree with her. Now, I've always thought messages in bottles are very, very cute. It's like a little part of history you're finding, because some of these messages go way, way back. It's like, wow, I'm holding this note that someone wrote back in like 1723 in an era I can't even imagine. It's like, wow, we're touching the same piece of paper. That's pretty damn dope.
Yeah, we should make one.
And then just put
send it out and then
bye.
See if the subscriber gets it.
No, just imagine, write it down, then just put your @ follow me on Instagram.
Yeah.
Put there.
That'd be cool though. Hey everyone, what's up and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm your host, Lindsay Ivan.
And I'm your other host, Eamon Hassan. And today we are bringing you the top 10 mysterious messages found in a bottle. Yes. Starting off this countdown, we have a new life. Back in 1970, Dorothy and John Peckham were on a holiday cruise and were in Hawaii at the time. To pass time and have some banter, they started writing notes and putting them in empty champagne bottles with a dollar as well and just throwing them into the Pacific. They kind of forgot about the entire thing until they got a response 4 years later.
13 years later, an ex-Vietnamese soldier named Hoa Van Nguyen found one of the bottles with his brother. The bottle was located off the coast of Thailand. Well, turns out that the brothers were trying to escape their miserable living conditions and set out on a raft. When they reached shore, they bought a stamp using the dollar in the bottle and mailed a letter back to the couple who sent the message. In the letter, they asked the Peckhams if they were able to help them leave Vietnam and relocate and start a new life in the US.
Dorothy and John were like, oh hell yeah, and did everything they could to make the immigration happen, and 2 years later the Nguyens moved to the US. Okay guys, let us know, is it Nguyens
or Nguyens?
We don't know.
I know someone named Nguyen with the last name Nguyen.
And I know someone with the last name Nguyen, so we really don't know. You know what I mean?
Whatever.
I don't know.
And they lived happily ever after. I just find it amazing how the couple sent out the message as a joke, yet it actually helped save someone's life.
Can you imagine, like, just a message in the bottle, like, oh, on a cruise, whoop. Never would have thought. Coming in at number 9 is The Castaway. The year was 1794 and the ocean was very rough due to extremely stormy conditions. Chunosuke Matsuyama, a Japanese seaman, had unfortunately chosen to travel a few days beforehand with 43 other companions. They were all on a mission to find some buried treasure, and treasure they did not find, but a storm they definitely did. The crew became shipwrecked on an island in the South Pacific with zero supplies and no forms of communication. The crew survived on crabs for a while before dying one by one, so Matsuyama decided to leave a message before he died as well. He carved a story about their misfortune into coconut wood and put it into a bottle and let it wash into the sea. No one had any idea what became of the group until the bottle was found 151 years later in 1935. A Japanese seaweed collector found it washed ashore in the village of Hiraturemura.
In our 8th spot, we have The Message from the Titanic. The sinking of the Titanic was a terrible tragedy. Over 1,500 people lost their lives with only 705 survivors. For those that lost their lives on the ship, it's sad that they didn't get to say their final goodbyes to the world. But one man did. While the ship was sinking, a young Irishman named Jeremiah Burke decided to write a message and conceal it in a bottle. Before Jeremiah set off for his trip, his mother gave him a small bottle of holy water. So he rolled up the message, put his note inside, and tossed it out to the sea. The note read, "From the Titanic, goodbye all, Burke of Glanmire, Cork." Sadly, Burke and his cousin perished in the sinking. But a year later, the message he sent out was found just a few miles from his home. It's crazy how it managed to get that close to his home. It seems like it was destined to reach his family, and it did.
Filling on number 7 saw are the lovers. Christmas Day 1945. World War II had just barely ended, and 21-year-old soldier Frank Hayostek was on his way home to begin anew. While on his transport ship, he thought to write a little letter and put it in a bottle and throw it overboard just to see what would come of it, if anything at all. 8 months later, the bottle washed up in Ireland and was found by a 19-year-old milkmaid called Breda O'Sullivan. Breda's like, ooh, a soldier, he's gonna be jacked and hot, let me reply to man's DM. She wrote back and thus started their 7-year long-distance relationship.
That's a long damn time. Well, 7 years later, Frank finally decided to go visit her in Ireland and meet her for the first time. But really, it took him 7 years to do so. Like, boys are so slow when it comes to these things. Like, come on, man.
How did it take him that long to realize, like, you know what, actually, I do kind of like her?
Now, he didn't make a lot of money, but he did manage to save enough to fly to Ireland. So cute. But by that point, the international press had heard about the star-crossed lovers and ambushed the couple as Frank arrived at the airport. He stayed there for a full 2 weeks and then left. No one knows what happened except the fact that the romance ended after the 2 weeks. Maybe it wasn't meant to be, or maybe Frank wasn't a jacked hot man like she thought.
I can't believe it. Catfished for 7 years. Now, at number six is the little kid. Back in 2016, a demolition crew in New Mexico found a time capsule dating all the way back to 1968. Inside the time capsule, they found a big bottle that had a bunch of letters inside that children had written. Now, judging by the contents of the letters, it kind of seemed like it was a fun school exercise or something. It was things like, my favorite drink is this, I like pizza, etc. But one letter was freaking weird, and it was written by Greg Lee Youngman. There's always that one creepy kid in every class, isn't there? Like, dude, relax. The letter said, I am dead. I go to Montgomery School. This is the olden school name. I was born in 1900. You ought to know I dead. My favorite subject is spooking the police. I play the guitar. In case you don't know what it is a board with strings on them. I am 10 years old. See you later, savages. Now, what kind of 10-year-old kid writes these things? Like, you have to be quite messed up to be like, I am dead. See you later, savages. But the end did make me chuckle. That's a bit of a mic drop moment. Good on you. I do like it.
We are now at our fifth and halfway mark with the dollar bill. This story was posted on a website that is dedicated to cracking messages found in bottles. So on October of 2011, a user posted a picture of a weird bottle they found at a beach. Inside the bottle was a rolled up dollar bill that had strange markings all over it. The markings are a mixture of scribbles and weird symbols. On one hand, some people believe that it's a coded message, whereas on the other hand, people believe that it's a treasure map. I'm thinking that if you fold it like origami style, then it will reveal a coded message. But for now, the mystery remains. Who sent out that message and what does it mean? Moving on to number four, we have the SOS.
Do you remember the Jonas Brothers song? This is an SOS.
I was thinking of the SOS, please someone help me. A couple years ago, a man named Paul Southworth was cleaning out debris from a pond when he discovered a bottle containing a secret message. The message was very faded from sun exposure and soaked with lake water, but you could clearly see the words SOS written on it. On one side of the note, it was written in German, and on the other side, it was written in English. It was presumed that they both say the same thing.
Now, the note read as follows. Please help us. We're in this place for a stupid disguise that has happened 1 year ago. We are two guys from Italy and Germany, and we are now on an island in France near Breton coast. Our parents know where is this place, so if you just write to one of them, better to advise both of them, we could be saved in no time.
The note then stated two addresses, but I don't think Paul did anything with this note, he just shared it online. So there literally could be people out there just stranded in need of his help.
Paul, you literally had one bloody job. But also kudos to the two guys that wrote it in German and translated it to English, but I'm also confused. What do they mean they went as disguise? Like,
I don't know.
Did they go as spies and now they want to go back to their old lives? Like, what do you mean?
That rhymed.
Filling out number three slot is the love match. I think this one is incredibly cute and almost like an old version of all these dating apps. So in 1956, a Swedish sailor called Åke Viking was lovesick, lonely, and desperate. As we all are at times, it happens to the best of us. Now he decided to throw caution to the wind and write a quick message to someone beautiful and far away, before corking it in a bottle and throwing it away. His love letter was found 2 years later by Paulina, a woman from Sicily. She replied saying, I'm not beautiful, but it seems so miraculous that this little bottle should have traveled so far and long to reach me that I must send you an answer. Modest, I like it. She probably was cute, let's be real. Now the two ended up in a long distance relationship before Viking moved to Sicily to marry Paulina. Hello, this is better than Romeo and Juliet, RT if you cry every time. Only if only love was that easy. What happened to that other couple? They lasted 7 years only to break up in 2 weeks after meeting each other. Lol.
Moving on to number two, we have the Lusitania. A couple years after the Titanic sank, the ocean liner, the Lusitania, followed in its lead. kind of. This ship was hit by a German torpedo in May of 1915 while on its way from New York to Liverpool. It took just 18 minutes for the ship to sink. During those 18 minutes, one passenger was able to write a note which he placed in a bottle. Many years later, it was found. The note read, "Still on deck with a few people. The last boats have left. We are sinking fast. Some men near me are praying with a priest. The end is near." And then it just cuts off like that. Why did he seal it up without finishing his thoughts? Did he run out of time? Did something else happen? I need answers. This is a big mystery.
And finally, at number one is the hex in a bottle. This story was shared by Reddit user MariahKL13 back in 2014. Now, one day the user went to the beach with some friends and she found a bottle. Dude, I've gone to the beach so many times in my life, I've never found a glass bottle. I found a bunch of empty plastic bottles just littered around, but not a glass bottle with a message for me. Now, the bottle contained pink water and a letter tied with a black ribbon. Why and how was the water pink, first of all? We don't know.
But here's the thing. When they drained the weird pink liquid, they discovered a photo of a woman wearing pink. I'm thinking that like water got in and then pink dye from the photo like—
Oh, true. Okay,
solved it. It seems pretty innocent, right? No, the photo was pierced several times with pins. It's believed that this was an attempt to put a curse on the woman in the photo. Kind of like a voodoo doll, but with a photo instead of the doll. But damn, that sucks. I hope this woman wasn't found drowned with tons of like puncture wounds all over her body. Also, what did she do to make someone want to put a hex on her? Seriously, it's not a typical thing that people do.
And was it necessary to like put it in a bottle and throw it away? Was it part of the hex, or was
they
that just like added?
They were gonna drown her, so they're like,
oh,
get
true.
Out.
In you go.
And that's all for today's video. Let's move on to our comment shout out portion.
We will be shouting out more comments from our video top 10 abandoned Disney projects.
Julia Michi commented, ship name, Amesley. Bam, you're welcome. I think that one's one of the best ones,
right? I really
like
that one.
Amesley, yeah.
Good one,
Sounds good. Brownie Time commented, I freaking love your accents. And I've been to Disney in Florida and I was supposed to go to Disney for my birthday, but the virus took that away from me. I understand your accent.
You have a Canadian accent though.
Mine's just normal.
No, but you're just saying that because you live here and everyone's Canadian, but yeah. you do have an accent. And hello, I'm sorry, belated happy birthday. I'm sorry you didn't get to go to Disneyland.
Yeah, belated happy birthday. Cassidy Rice commented, I would love to get a birthday shout out because my birthday is this Friday the 31st. Happy birthday, Cassidy Rice. Hope you have a good one.
Leo Gang, hello. Love you. This one's from TreePelt97. I want top 10 deaths at Disney or unusual deaths or disappearances. I feel like some people have died or disappeared at Disney. This would be quite easy to
cover
do.
Cover up.
We're coming for you. Lulu Laffy says, hi, most amazing top 10. I was watching one of you guys' videos. My brother got really interested and he wanted to watch it too at night. I could hear from my room. He was calling my mom to come to his room. And then he said to her, I'm scared because I watched the most amazing top 10. Then my mom said, where did you find this channel? He said, from my big sister. My mom went to my room and said, you have to unsubscribe to most amazing top 10. And I was not allowed to watch the most amazing top 10 for 2 weeks. Firstly, wow. That was a roller coaster of emotions.
That was a rant.
Good on you for scaring your little brother. Yeah, we need to have a chat with your mom. What do you mean unsubscribe? Your daughter's old enough to watch us. Yeah. Just don't watch at night.
No.
And don't show your little brother, he's probably tiny.
And that's all the comments we're showing out for today's video. Make sure to comment something down below for a chance to be featured in our next comment shout out. And as always, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan.
I've been your other host, Eamon Hassan.
And I'll see you when I see you.
Bye.
You look so dressy and I look like I'm...
Dude, like just... literally like nothing is dressy about me right now.
Okay, well it looks like
they
I got
knew what
out
was
of
going
it.
On inside. I'm literally holding a fire right now, so it's fine. Literally,
always.
It's all good.
Well, turns out that the brothers were trying to escape their
World War II had just barely ended and 21-year-old soldier Frank Hoyo... Well, I don't know. Hayostek?
I'm the worst at pronouncing names, so don't ask me.
Okay.
Oh, it's both of us. I was like, I'm going.
They went as disguise, like,
I don't know.
Did they go as spies and now they want to go back to their old lives? Like, what do you mean?
That rhymed. Did they go as spies in disguise, want to go back to their old lives? Wow. That was really good.
Thank you. You did it though.
Yeah, I know. Oh, let me try and get this name. Lusitania.
Lusitania.
Lusitania? You know it?
Yeah.